and we do not boast. Stampeded on the super eagles of Nigeria, we broke their wings and sent them back to watch a witchcraft movie. We send them back to Nigeria to concentrate on the very serious business of selling cocaine in Lagos. They goes. When the ivory elephants, they comes. The super eagles, they goes. The indomitable lions of Cameroon, tonight they were over the moon. Because they think they got away in Rooney, in Samuel Eto'o, Kitugani hiyo, Ati Eto'o. That's all he do. He goes, like Klamski in the loop when he flash. That's all. Place the penalty over the post. The elephants harumph. Stop. Then Drogba, the dragon, stepped up to the bar and shot team Drogbaski. When the elephants of the Ivory Coast, they come a-calling, lions indomitable or not, they go. Tonight, if the Teranga Lions of Senegal with their fan make it to the final, we shall panga Teranga like a malaya remove the ivory panga. Sema Senegal, Senghor, where are you? Then send them to the twilight land of yore. Because when elephants stampede, the grass it grows no more. If we meet the Arabs of Egypt, those ancient pharaohs of yore, Cairo shall fall. Alexandria will be crushed beneath the big feet of the black ivory elephants. The crocodiles of the Nile shall no longer smile or eat people because the elephants will have banged out their golden teeth. There shall be no more white people like Blondie singing about walking like Egyptians. They shall sing a new song. It shall be called Walk Like an Ivorian. They shall sing all the women in West Africa. They shake their ass like they are Kenyan. And the Kenyan. So walk like an Ivorian. And when Cote d'Ivoire lifts the ivory trophy, there shall be trumpet. A room! Because the Sphinx shall lose its nose again like Michael Jackson. The Egyptians will go to Bahrain. They shall strip in the rain. Tutankhamen shall say amen. Cleopatra at a Tupambao, Mubarak at a Butabooms, Isis and Osiris shall kiss and say, eh, kumbe ni Ivory Coast. When the elephants come a calling, we need it.
Whether we've heard of her or not. that intimidates me is the fact that I speak and write in English, and I lost my mother tongue very early on in life. My mother tongue is Gujarati from the central western part of India. Do we have any Gujaratis in the house?
Yeah!
Hey, Gujaratis in the house. The children in my dreams speaking Gujarati turn their trusting faces to the sun, say to me, "Keep us, nurture us." In my dreams, I shudder and I run. I am six in a playground of white children. Doggy, sing us an Indian song. Eight in a room full of elders, all mock my broken Gujarati. English girl. 12, I tunnel into books, forge an armor of English words. 18, cropped hair, combat boots. Shamed by grannies in white saris, neon judgments singe my western head. Mother tongue, Matru Basha. Through the years, I watch Gujarati swell the swaggering egos of men, mirror them over and over at twice their natural size. Through the years, I watch Gujarati dissolve bones and teeth of women, break them on anvils of duty and service, burn them to skeletal ash. Words that don't exist in Gujarati. Self-expression. Individual. Lesbian. English rises in my throat, rapier flashed at yuppie boys who claim their people civilized mine. Babies in arms, pack them onto foreign planes like battery chickens, tell the pilots down the rifle barrels, leave. We don't care where you take them, leave. And I learn, like a stone in my gut, that third generation Asian Kenyan will never be Kenyan enough. That all my pressure of exam after exam, where second place is never good enough, they snap, their faces taut with fear. You can't be soft. You must be strong. You have to fight or the world will eat you up. 70 shillings to the pound. They hug us, tearless, stoic, at airports, as we board planes for icy, alien England. Cram instructions into our pockets like talismans. Cover your ears against the cold. Eat proper meals so you don't get sick. Stay away from the mafathias, the ones without purpose and values. Learn and study, succeed. Learn and study, succeed. Remember, remember, remember the cost of your life. They never say they love us. I watch how I love. I admonish, exhort. Like a Himalayan guide, I rope my chosen ones, yank them remorselessly up when they don't even want to be on the frigging mountain. Of all the birds up here, open up the space, smile for the cameras. This is your chance to say hi to everyone back home. We have cameras in the house. How many slam poets get to be on TV their first time up on the mic? This is pretty important. Some of us have to wait 5 years for this. Start by saying that every single person who gets on this stage tonight is a winner, because it takes courage to be up here. So let's applaud all the winners up here tonight. And I'm going to announce the 5 top scorers in from lowest to highest. In 5th place, we have the man who walks like an Ivorian, Tony Machama. In 4th place, we have Rishabh with a score of 21. In 3rd place, we have the woman who grapples with ideas, Yvonne with 24.2. We have the man who hates poetry, Ryan. And the winner of Nairobi's first ever poetry slam with a top score of 26.0, Dugni. June out there? took the top three places. The third prize is a copy of Kwani, that throbbing hub of Kenyan literature. The second prize is a copy of Kwani and free entry to the next poetry slam or the next Kwani open mic. And the first prize winner gets a copy of Kwani and a full-length feature, the kind you just saw me do. You'll hear 15 to 20 minutes of his work at the next Kwani open mic. For you, okay? You can say wave at the cameras and go talk to the journalists who want to be there. We do have a lot of journalists in that.
This poem is a bit personal. Just to suggest that opposites values can come together and, you know, make some kind of unity. And it's titled The Bride and Groom. So if you can imagine yourself getting married just for a few seconds here, it's a very short poem. So let's just make believe and let's see how we can get ourselves wet.